as I'm wrapping up the final touches here, before I can go in and sculpt out the teeth, we need to create more space between the jaw and the top of the mouth. I'll quickly paint in a mask along the already carved in area for the mouth. Now inverse the mask, and I can use the move brush or clay buildup brush to really carve in this area to create more space for the inside of the mouth. Once I've created that space, as I've made some large shape adjustments to the mesh, I'll quickly re-DynaMesh the surface. I want to pull open the mouth a bit more to make space for the teeth on the top and the bottom. The easiest method here is to mask and then make adjustments. We can use the mask pen, but it's a bit difficult to get in here and paint in a clean mask on the inside. In this case, it would be better to introduce a different masking brush called the mask lasso brush. Press and hold the control key, and let's click open the masking brush's palette. Here is the mask lasso brush, and let's select it by clicking on it. So let's go in and draw a mask with this brush by pressing and holding control, and we'll draw our cursor over the canvas. This brush will allow us to draw more dynamic masking shapes over the entire surface for a broader masking selection on the character. If we press and hold control and alt, we can draw over the masked areas and erase those areas to create more interesting masking shapes. Let's clear the mask and use this brush to select the portion of the jaw. We can view the character from the front view and press control and draw a shape around the jaw. The mask lasso brush will work a bit differently than the mask pen brush and will travel through the entire mesh. So you can see on the backside here, we also have a masked area. In this case, let's clear the mask and rotate to the side view so we don't accidentally affect the area in the back of the character. I'll redraw the mask around the jaw. Now inverse the mask and we can use the move brush to pull down the jaw to create more space. Now keeping the mask and inversing again, we can now pull up the top of the face to create even more space between them. Clear the mask, and now I can go in with the clay buildup to carve out the inside of the mouth even further, and also re-DynaMesh the surface to add more resolution for sculpting. I'm continuing to sculpt inside of the mouth with the clay buildup brush to define the gums. When we've got a clear definition of these shapes, we now need to go in and start pulling out the teeth. I'm going to carve in some holes where I want the teeth to go. I want to sort of create this overlap of the bite between the teeth. So at the top, I'm carving in two holes with a space in the middle for the bottom tooth to fit. So going down the line of teeth, I can carve in these markers and creating a little space between each hole. Now using the mask pen brush, and I'm going to go in here and paint in a mask inside of each of these holes. I'll inverse the mask now and use the move brush to start pulling out the teeth from the surface. We can pull down all of the teeth with a large draw size and then adjust the draw size a bit smaller and scale into each individual tooth to pull them down at different lengths. Before I clear the mask, I want to smooth the tips of the teeth to create the tooth shape. So going in and using the smooth option to smooth across each tooth. If you find yourself heavy-handed with the smooth brush and are accidentally smoothing and shrinking the shapes too much, simply press and hold the shift key and we can go and adjust the Z intensity of the smooth brush lower in order to reduce how much we're destroying the shapes we've pulled out for the tooth. I'll clear the mask and before I move forward with sculpting, re-DynaMesh the surface and then smooth out those surfaces. Moving down to the bottom teeth, following the same steps as above, and once again re-DynaMesh the surface for clean sculpting. If you happen to run into an area like this where DynaMesh is merging a tooth that is close to another surface, it's because the surface areas are too close and DynaMesh is seeing it as one piece and will merge the geometry. To fix this, we can simply undo the DynaMesh action and go back with the move brush to pull this further away from that area, and then re-DynaMesh. We now have all of the shapes of the teeth, so all that is needed now is to do some further refining. So, spending the time to make small adjustments with the move brush to adjust the overall shapes and sizes of each tooth. I can adjust the overall distance and placement of the top row and bottom row by also using the mask lasso brush further. And I can adjust the jaw to get a desired look. Using this mask to protect the top, I could go in and give him an underbite or create even more space between the mouth to start creating more of an open-mouthed expression. One last thing on the mouth I would like to start adding is just some more final details to this area, specifically the lips and shapes around the teeth. As we've been shaping and pulling out the entire character from our original ball of clay, we're slowly starting to lose the sculpting resolution even as we DynaMesh the surface. When we reach this point during our sculpting process, now is the time to raise the resolution settings for DynaMesh. Let's navigate to the DynaMesh options. So, DynaMesh resolution will vary depending on how far we've shaped and pulled out from the original sphere. In order to add resolution, we simply need to adjust the resolution slider higher. Now, there's no need to raise the resolution too high from our original starting resolution of 128, as it has done a very good job of maintaining the details so far. And it's best to work towards the end of our sculpt and slowly raise the resolution slider when we need to. So I'll adjust the resolution just a bit higher to something around 300, and then re-DynaMesh the surface. The higher the resolution, the longer it will take DynaMesh to process the entire mesh, and could take a couple tries to land on a resolution that works for what we need. So if needed, adjust the resolution to the necessary level again and re-DynaMesh the surface. I'll smooth out this surface just a bit and go in and apply some details to make sure this is enough for me to continue sculpting. In this case, I like the resolution that I'm getting from my brushes, so this is more than enough for me to add some final touches and move on. Switching to the standard brush, I'm going in and carving out areas around the teeth to accentuate lips sitting around and on top of the teeth, and then continue on to sculpt and refine these areas. Now that we have more resolution with our DynaMesh, we can focus on adding all of these final details for the rest of the character. So this could mean adding in holes for nostrils with the standard brush, using the damn standard brush to accentuate the eyelids even more by building up around the edges and also carving underneath, using the standard brush to add crease lines around the skin for the stomach, and then using the damn standard brush to carve in those lines for even further details. Also, using the move brush to adjust the overall shape and silhouette of the character while rotating around at all angles. And then continuing to add all of these other final touches on the character following all of these same techniques we've learned so far. And by doing so, I've been able to come up with a final design for the character. Now, I could continue as far as I want to take this and add more details or shapes, but for now, this covers all that is needed to get you started. At a very basic level, we are able to use the tools discussed throughout this series to design something in ZBrush very quickly and easily. If you decided to work on your own style or design, following all of these basic applications and techniques will apply to almost any creature or character, and as you progress, you'll find many other tips and tricks along the way by exploring the Z Classroom library, focusing on all different styles of art. In the next series of videos, we'll be moving on from the sculpting phase and adding paint to the mesh to breathe even more life into this character. Thanks for visiting Z Classroom, and I'll see you in the next video.